What's good, y'all? Shout out to my Skins fans. We just got another W. You feel me? We just beat the Bucks in their house, took their cookies, literally took their cookies, forced fumbles, got two interceptions. That's what I'm told. The defense stepped up, man. They made plays, they forced turnovers. Something that they weren't able to do last week. They weren't able to force turnovers and they got ran all over and thrown over. They definitely redeemed themselves. Fitzpatrick did still get some yardage here and there. He got some big plays a little bit here and there. But once it got to the red zone, they locked in. Swearinger batted down some passes. Kerrigan got back there. Preston Smith, Ioannidis. Preston Smith stepped up. Give credit where credit is due. That last play where he had a sack on him and Kerrigan punched the ball out, that was a big play by Preston Smith right there. Greg Stroman with the interception. Josh Norman with the interception. The defense played hard, man. They forced fumbles. They made plays. Ryan Anderson punched the ball out on Jacquizz Rodgers. That was a big punch. You could just see it coming. The guys were just kept raking at the football, trying to punch the ball out and make plays. That's something the Skins defense has been able to do this year that they haven't been able to do in previous years, which is force fumbles and just force turnovers. Once again, we win the turnover battle. Alex Smith. He made some plays here and there. You know, he threw the ball to Doxson. He threw the ball to Mo Harris. Threw a pass to Michael Floyd once. He made some plays here and there. He didn't get over 200 yards, or he didn't even get to 200 yards passing, which is typical Alex Smith. But hey, he's a game manager. He managed the game well. He didn't throw any interceptions, and you know, he just got the ball down the field once or twice on two or three drives and made plays. And Doxson stepped up. He didn't drop the football. That was huge. Josh Doxson did not drop the football. That is something to be posted on the news. He did not drop the football all game. He made plays, caught a big touchdown catch. So shout out to Josh Doxson. Way to step up, man. There was some questionable play calling by Jay Gruden. Of course, we ran out of timeouts early. That was not a good thing at all. Almost had some delay of game plays here and there. But, hey, I'm happy with the win, man. And it shows you how crazy the NFL is. The Falcons just got beat up on by the Browns, and that's the team that we just got blown out by. And the Browns are not a good team this year at all. Haven't been a good team in the past years, but it just shows how crazy the NFL is, man. That shows that the NFL is not predictable all the time, unfortunately, like the NBA is right now. The NFL is not predictable. You know, teams step up, and, you know, I did not think by any means the Redskins were going to be 6-3 right now back in August. When the preseason or the season started, if somebody said the Redskins were going to be 6-3, I'm telling you, I wouldn't bet money on it. I really wouldn't, you know. But the Redskins are proving me wrong, man. And I think, you know, we play the Texans next week, or whoever we play. It's going to be a tough game. We just got to keep winning ugly. Hashtag win ugly. That's the motto for the Skins. Hashtag win ugly. My MVP for this game. This is tough. Adrian Peterson didn't have a 100-yard game. He still had a good game. But my MVP for this game, it's a tough one. I'm just going to go collectively with the defense. I don't think one player really stood out. I guess I'll go with the defensive line. They stepped up and played big. Shout out to Swearinger again, though. Ioannidis stepped up as well. But all right, y'all. Peace. Another victory. 6-3 top of the NFCs. Let's go. And the Cowboys about to take an L to the Eagles tonight. Let's go. Hail to them Skins. All right, y'all. Peace.